Hey y'all, and welcome to Spare Room. I'm Karen Terry, and today we're going to talk about naming your characters. You can make the most amazingly intricate character or the simplest NPC, but no matter what, every character needs a name, if for no other reason than just the practicality of what to call them. Out of all of the character creation tasks that you might do, this is the one that you're going to do virtually every time. So there are lots of methods of picking a character name. We're going to highlight a few of the things that you might want to consider and methods that you might want to use. The first thing to remember when it comes to character names is that most people don't pick their own name. Their parents pick it for them. So remember when we talked about the five essential things you need to know about your character? In that video, one of those things was the character's family. So if you're struggling with your character's name, maybe wait until after you've made the character's family, then come back to the name. When considering what kind of name a parent might pick for their child, first think about that parent's values. Are they the sort of person that would name their child after themselves, or maybe a relative or a close family friend? If they are, then these are great name choices. If not, maybe would they do this for a middle name? It's also worth considering nicknames. Prospective parents will think about what nicknames might work for their child depending on the name that they pick. So consider James as a name. If someone is named James, they might go by James, or Jim, or Jimmy, or Jimbo, and these are things to think about when it comes to naming a character, because these are things that parents are going to think about when they're naming their child. It's also important to consider the parent's culture of origin, and depending on that particular person's values, they might decide to follow the naming conventions of their culture or deliberately break from them. When you're thinking about the parents' values, think about where they might fall on that spectrum. Consider, for example, a pair of immigrant parents. Do they name their children something that honors their country of origin, or do they decide that assimilation for their children is really important to them, so they name them something that matches the country they've moved to? Both of these choices are valid. You'll just need to think about what the parents' values are and what they might think is important. If you're writing in a fantasy culture, consider the culture for those people. Let's think about Hunger Games, for example. They have names like Katniss, Gale, Thresh, Rue, Peeta. Their names center around work and nature and food because these are the types of values that they have in those cultures. And then if you look at the richer districts, you have names like Kashmir and Glitter, and that defines the values of those richer districts. If you're playing Dungeons & Dragons, the player's handbook has example names for each of the races. So if you're doing something that's a very like traditional, typical fantasy, then I would look at the Dungeons & Dragons player's handbook name suggestions to get ideas for character names. So what if your character didn't get their name from their parents? You'll still need to think about who gave them that name and what that person's values are. So if they were raised by foster parents, what were the foster parents' values, for example? Maybe you're writing some darker themes like in Game of Thrones and you've got a character that was a slave. So Grey Worm, for example, was given his name by his master. So you would want to think about those master's values. Is this character someone who picked their own name? Maybe they're trans and picked a new name when they transitioned. Or maybe they're in trouble with the law and had to change their name to hide their identity. Just like when considering the parents, no matter who it is that picked the name, you'll need to consider that person's values and culture of origin. This is going to ultimately define what kind of name someone's going to pick. So once you've established who is going to pick the name, their culture of origin, and their values, you've narrowed down significantly what types of names you might pick from. Name meanings are also really fun to play with in this context, and most baby name websites will list the meaning of a name. So it can be really fun to think about, okay, what sort of things do I want to highlight about this character, and put in that meaning and see what sorts of things pop up that fit the values and culture of origin that you've already decided on earlier. If this character is in a modern setting or a relatively recent setting, it can also be fun to look up lists of popular names for that year. And this is really good for when you're needing to pick like NPC names, because if it was a really popular baby name that year, it's almost guaranteed that your character knows somebody with that name. Now, at this point, hopefully you have a relatively short list of possible names for that character. When you're looking at that list of names, I would recommend sounding them out, thinking about what they're going to look like when they're written, thinking about what the character's initials are going to spell out. Did they spell out something obnoxious? If so, we probably wouldn't pick those. Or maybe they spell out something meaningful for the character. Next, I would recommend checking what you've done against other characters you've created and names you've chosen for them. People tend to enjoy the same sounds and combinations of sounds, so if you're naming a lot of characters, your names can start to sound sort of samey. So to avoid this, check the name against all of the other names that you've come up with. And if you're starting to notice a certain pattern, then think about breaking away from that pattern either in this character or in future characters. And when all else fails, go to whatever your favorite baby name website is. If you're a writer or a role player, I'm sure that you have one. And just start browsing. Write down names that you think sound cool or interesting, and that way you have a bank of names that you can always go to whenever you're making a new character. So these are the things that I like to think about when picking out names for characters. Does any of this match what you guys think about? Are there maybe additional things that you guys think about? Let me know down below. And remember to like if you like this video, comment down below with any questions that you have, subscribe for more videos, click that bell for notifications, all the links to my social media down in the doobly-doo. Thank you so much for watching and make it a great day.